Hi everyone, this is Brendan here. Welcome to my next episode, Day23 of my Let's Clash series. So I decided to upgrade one of my wall after my Archer Tower finishes upgrade to level 4. So going ahead to do my next upgrade, which is the gold mine, upgrading it in 1 hour's time. So after 1 hour, it got to level 4 and I decided to upgrade it to level 5, which requires 2 hours to upgrade. So I was quite busy in the morning, so I didn't want to do a lot of raiding, and then I just wait for the gold mines to actually complete its upgrades. So after that, going for an attack on this 200 over 1000 gold available base, and then going ahead to attack this Town Hall 9. The gold mines, they were pretty easy to get because they're all exposed, and also the gold, most of them, they were inside the gold mine. As you can see, the storages, they were very empty, especially if you look at the one on the top, the one that is the lowest in level, is very empty, and also the gold mines, they're very full. So I just focus my troops on the gold mine, not even bothering about the gold storages. And then the dark elixir drill, it didn't really occur to me that I would actually want to get it, but eventually my troops got it, especially when my dark elixir is actually at the max capacity right now of 10,000. So going ahead with the next attack on this Town Hall 9 again, and then the gold storages, as you can see, they are very empty, and the gold mines, they're very full. Just focusing on them, taking out the wizard tower on the right side first, otherwise my troops will get fried up by the wizard towers. So focusing on the gold mines, and then as you can see, the X-Bow is also out of ammo. Although they are pointing up, doesn't mean that they are out of ammo. You have to look at the back of the ammo box, which actually is a purple color box. So if the box isn't there, means that the ammo is out, and then the X-Bow basically hasn't any ammo left, so it won't be able to shoot any arrows. So going ahead back to my base, and then eventually my upgrade completed, and then going ahead to remove one of the trunk, which gave me 5 gems, and then going ahead to do some upgrades of the walls as I farmed a little bit gold. And then as you can see on my research lab, another 13 more hours till my archer will get to level 4. So I was hoping for it to get to level 4, and then now upgrading my gold mine to the next level. So I was trying to focus more on my gold mines as I wanted to get them to a higher level a little bit, so that I could get more gold out of it. I also could prepare for my next tower level, as I could use the gold mines to actually adjust the building time of my builders. Next time I'll explain more and go into detail. So I do not want to get all my buildings as in 1 day, 2 days, 3 days building. I want to have some buildings with like 6 hours, 12 hours, or in fact like 4 hours build time, so that I could adjust my timing of my builders, especially if, like, for example, I will be free to play for only say 6 hours, then after that 6 hours I won't be free. So of course I will do an upgrade for 6 hours building, then after that I will just do the next upgrade after the 6 hour of gameplay. Then after that, I will just go and do my stuff. So if I know that I'm going to be not free for the next few hours, then I'll plan my time well enough so that I could do my upgrade, and eventually I don't have to rush to get back onto Clash to do any upgrades, or in fact farm for any resources, any extra resources, which I have to rush my way through it. So now farming a little bit, just upgrading my walls, as the time is very short for the upgrade time of the gold mines right now, just only 1 hour, 2 hours, so it just requires a little bit of farming here and there, and then after that I just use the gold and put all into the wall as usual. So going ahead for this attack, 361,000 gold available. So the gold mines, they're all very full, not looking at the gold storages, as they were pretty empty for this base, as this guy didn't have any shield. As you can see on the top left, he wasn't in any league, although it was like around day 9 of the league already, so we can obviously say that this guy's base has already been rather inactive. So of course the gold is usually all inside the gold mines. It's called like a dead base, so most of the time people will just farm the gold mines and not bother about the gold storages, because usually most of the time these kind of bases won't have gold inside the gold storages, unless maybe this guy came in to just jam up his gold storages and then just left it over there. But most of the time the gold mines are the one that will have all the resources. So going back to my base again, the gold mine is completed, upgrading another gold mine to the next level. So 1 hour later, we have to wait for that. So going ahead to do a few raids within that 1 hour. I was slightly more free during this time period, because after the morning I was more free, in fact in the afternoon, so I could do more raids, do a little bit more farming, and then get more resources to upgrade my walls. So going ahead to attack this Town Hall 8, and then just deploying my troops and focusing them at the bottom, because a lot of the resources were at the bottom, and I didn't really bother about the top, especially when the top, they didn't really have a lot of resources. But the mortar on the right side there, I could have taken a mortar out using some barbarians, using some more extra barbarians to try to take that mortar out. Otherwise, my archers would be able to take out the army camp over there. But yeah, I made a mistake on that part. But not to worry, my troops are just going in to try to do a little bit more damage. As now you can see, the Barbarian King is just soaking up the damage, following up by the archers and also by the wizard, but they all gone down really quickly. Couldn't even get the one star, but not to worry, going back to my base, the gold mine completed its upgrade. And then eventually I went to do a little bit more upgrade of the walls. As you can see, I stocked up 900 over 1000 gold in just around 1 hour or so. So able to use up all the gold onto the upgrade. So today's farming was pretty good, pretty alright. Especially when in just one hour I could farm like around 800, 900 over 1000 gold, not even having any boost. And taking into consideration that I'm quite low in league, so I'm trying to push my way up to around 1600. Because that league, I really favor farming that league for Town Hall 7 and Town Hall 8. But of course, it won't be easy for me to farm, and especially whenever I go offline, people will just 3-star my base easily, and then I will be able to lose a lot of resources. That's why whenever I go offline, I try to go offline with as low of a goal as possible, so that I do not lose a lot of goal. So this raid, as you can see, the gold mines, they're all just behind one layer of wall, very easy to farm, not gonna use a lot of troops. And then eventually I stole majority of the gold from the gold mines and just ending the battle, losing the raid, saving a lot of troops. So going ahead to find this 754,000 gold available base, when I saw this base, I was like, whoa, another 1 million loot base. And yesterday I actually found one. And then just decided to just go ahead for this attack. As you can see, it's relatively easy to farm, but also not too easy because some of the gold mines, they're behind the walls. So now, as you can see, I just focus on the town hall first, getting the town hall to secure the win. And then eventually, once my troops, they are being deployed, they were going ahead to get the gold mines, the gold, they're all inside the gold mines. And especially the gold mines, they're all behind the wall, so it was pretty hard to get the gold inside the gold mines. And the storages, they were pretty full, so it was also quite hard to get all the gold on this base. So of course, I was just focusing my troops on the gold mine, and my wizards, hopefully they could get the last gold mine on the left side. However, they diverted and went left and right and couldn't get even one hit on the gold mine, especially when they got taken out by the cannon and also the archer tower over there. But yeah, this is a mistake on my part, but not to worry, we got a lot of gold in that 1 hour time span and managed to get 800 over 1000 gold. So going ahead for another few more upgrades, upgrading my walls again, and then eventually getting most of them to dark purple crystal wall, almost getting all of them to dark purple crystal wall already, just left with around 20 over walls left, which I've gotten from the new town hall level of town hall 7. So of course I want to upgrade all of them to the max level possible, which is level 7 for my current town hall level. So I'll have to work my way up again, just another one or two more days to get all of them to max level. So getting my dark elixir barracks now, so hopefully be able to get minions, be able to use them to farm using the BAM strategy. But of course, the level 1 minions to me, they are practically useless, so I have to upgrade them to level 3 before I start using them. Level 3 minions are like the minimum level before I'll actually start using them. Level 1 and 2, they are practically they go down really quickly, especially even getting damaged by archer towers. So I don't really favor to use them, as especially their damage is also pretty low. So going ahead for this 417,000 gold available base. So as you can see, there are 4 gold mines at the bottom, so I have to spread my troops out in such a way whereby the gold mines will be able to be taken out by my barbarians and archers. So at the left side especially, I focus my barbarians and archers over there on the gold mine alone over there. So I had to use my archers to shoot over the wall, definitely, because the wall breakers weren't available for me to use for this army combo. So I definitely have to switch it up a little, use maybe one or two wall breakers in my next few episodes. So hopefully be able to add that in, even though they are level 3 or level 4, but having them on my army will be definitely awesome. So going ahead with the next attack on this 268,000 gold available base, not as high as the previous base, but it's definitely much easier because the gold mines, they're all outside of the wall. So for the buildings that are outside of the wall, your barbarians can attack them, whereas if they are behind a layer of wall, you won't be able to attack them. So that's a hint for you guys as to how to design your base. especially for those of you who actually do not collect your gold mines and your elixir collectors, it's recommended to put them behind the walls. Whereas for me, I do come online very often, so I do not have to put them behind the wall. So when I design my base in the next few episodes, once I reach the Town Hall 8 expansion, I'll be changing my base a little, so I won't be putting my gold mines outside. So going ahead, now you can see my archers have gotten to level 4. Going ahead to upgrade and research my barbarian to level 4, the next one, and then hopefully get them to level 5 once I get to Town Hall 8. So going ahead to test out level 4 archers, and of course with just level 3 barbarians, as to see how much damage they deal as compared to level 3 archers. So they do a little bit more damage, but with so many archers in your army, it's definitely important to upgrade your barbarians and archers as soon as possible, because if you're just going to compare say one archer and then increasing by one level, the damage increase isn't a lot. But if you take into consideration that you're using like 100 archers, so the damage increase will be so significant that if they all shoot onto one building at one time, the building will be able to be dealt with more damage as compared to the previous level. So now as you can see, my wizards and also the barbarian king has broken through trying to get the gold mine, but then the barbarian king didn't go for the gold mines. But not to worry, he's going for the gold mine soon, and the wizards will support from the back, taking out the last few bits of gold. And then eventually I had no choice but to just surrender, won't be able to take out the rest of the remaining 91,000 gold. So yeah, that was a pretty awesome raid. So going back to my base, now as you can see, my spell factory has finished its upgrade. So now I have level 2 spells factory, and then I'll be able to unlock healing spells. So I have 2 spells available, 2 lightning spells that I'm going to prepare, and then I won't have to wait too long for another lightning spell. I'll be able to use it to lightning the clan castle troops. If the clan castle, they contain barbarians and archers, which I have not shown you guys yet, usually I use them to lightning the troops so that they do not harass my troops, especially when they are all inside the base and they're all attacking halfway, and then the clan castle do come out and they harass my troops. So that's something that I'll be able to show you guys in the next few episodes, hopefully once I have more lightning spells to use, which now I have 2. So going ahead to upgrade some of the walls, and then after that just spending all the gold, and then I was trying to conserve my gold, hoping to have a remainder of 80,000 gold or more. And then after that, I'll be able to use that 80,000 gold to upgrade my archer tower to the next level, because I wanted to go to bed already. So the archer tower will take 12 hours to upgrade. So in that 12 hours, I'll be able to have my rest, which is my sleep. At the same time, I will be able to farm again in the morning. Once I wake up, like around roughly 6 to 7 hours later, I'll be able to farm for the next 5 to 6 hours, and hopefully be able to get a bit more gold, to get maybe around 3 million or 4 million gold. 4 million will be quite tough, but yeah, I will try my best. So hopefully be able to get the 3 million gold, and then after that upgrade finish all my walls, as I roughly need around 3.2 million more gold to finish all the upgrades for the walls before I go into Town Hall 8. So yeah, that's it for this particular episode. Hope you guys have enjoyed it. As now you can see, my attack wins have increased a lot, 456. And then my gold grab has also increased a lot as compared to the previous episode. So the next Town Hall 8, hopefully my achievements for the gold grab and also the elixir escapade can complete before that too. Before Town Hall 9, sorry. It'll be quite impossible to complete it before Town Hall 8 though. So yeah, that's it for this particular episode. Hope you guys enjoy it. So with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my episode and also supporting me throughout the whole entire series, and also to clash on.